Alright, we made it. It only took me 3 tries. Now let's see how the boss goes. So yeah, the only thing you want to buy here is the key, Lingrass's key, and I would go ahead and buy a firebomb, just one. And I will show you why later. And the key unlocks the blacksmith in Majula, which is essential. Be sure to exhaust this lady's dialogue, because she will also move back to Majula if you exhaust her dialogue. Okay. See if I can get this crystal lizard here. Okay, nope, definitely not. Alright, well, I'm not even gonna try, honestly. I'm just gonna try again next time. Let's see on... What is this? Yeah, okay, that should hit it. If I get on top of it at the right time. Although, actually, is the hand axe better than this? It is. It's, like, way better in every single way. And it doesn't break, like, immediately. I believe the... That's kind of a downward chop, but really what I'm looking for is, hold on. No. Is it a... Well, I mean, the jump attack will definitely work, but is it a running R1? Is it the one-handed running R1? Yes, it is. That is a downward swing. That is what I'm looking for, to kill that lizard. Okie doke. Let's go ahead and rest at the bonfire. Take another crack at that crystal lizard. I can hear it. There we go. Just a couple of running R1s. Cut it right down. Let's go ahead and go into the next area here, which is down here. What you got, buddy? You ain't got jack. Get a nice soul. Oh, this guy's waking up. Did you have a nice sleep, sweetie pie? Oh, shit. Here we go. Alright, that guy's dead. Now let's keep going. Do-do-do-do-do. And there's this dude. Sure to kill him. Oh, shit. Oh, I shouldn't have... See, I'm not playing right. I'm not playing right. Keep, like, two-handing this axe. I know, just keep the shield out. It's important. Shield's important. But I keep trying to, like, play this as something it's not. And, yeah. Oh, shit. Let's stand there and get hit by a fucking arrow for no reason. Go ahead and equip your firebomb, because you're gonna want it. And be sure to get shot by a bunch of arrows. That's important. Dodge this guy. Alright, this is why you need the firebomb. And now you have a shortcut back to the bonfire. See? Isn't that nice? It's nice to have. Yeah, just aim it at that huge stack of barrels, and you'll be fucking golden every time. Let's go ahead and run back down this way, because there is one thing that we need over here. And there will be only one thing that I will grab. And I'm not going to fight pretty much any of these enemies, because there's a bunch of items over here, and you can explore around a little bit if you want. But again, I really just don't give a shit. I'm not here to fight enemies. I'm here to get good. And in the quest to get good, this is what you need to do. Don't fucking sprint in here, because you will get hit by that and you will die. And you'll be very sad. Talk to this dude. So, okay, this dude, he's a crazy map maker. He's a cartographer. He makes maps. And he came to Drang Lake. He doesn't know why. But he owns a house in Majula. And he gives you the key. He gives you the key to his fucking house. You just met him in a tunnel, and he's just like, here's my fucking... Here, you can have my house. But I also want to live there. So it's really more of a roommate situation. And I gotta be honest, I'm not comfortable with that kind of living situation. It's a very, not a healthy dynamic, in my opinion. Anyway, so which way do you go here now? Is it back out here? Yes, it is. Okay. Go back out here, climb this ladder. Do-do-do-do-do. Nope, no. Take shield out. Oh, I missed. And I got hit with an arrow. Oh. I'll just go ahead and drink here. Well, still got healed to full health. I seriously don't know how arrows are doing that much damage. That's so ridiculous. And they stagger every hit. There's gotta be something that's just fucked up about my stats that is doing that. Anyway, so here's what you're gonna wanna do. Climb up this ladder. Run to this body right here. Pick up the Estus Plask Yard and then get the fuck out. Do not stay. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. Run back to the bonfire as fast as you fucking can. Oh, phew. So what happens on top of that roof is you can fight one of the bosses here early if you are so inclined. I am not so inclined to do that. I'm not here to fight bosses. I'm here to get good. And fighting one of the bosses early is not a part of the plan. Let me see if I can talk to this guy. Yeah, buddy. Oh, shit. Here they come. Pate, help me! Pate is that guy that I was just talking to. Mild Manner Pate, that's his name. He's an asshole. He doesn't help you. Bro! Okay, I'm out of stamina. It's alright. Okay, well, fuck you, Pate. Didn't help me anything. But that's alright. We powered through. What do you got to say for yourself, Pate?
I'll leave this one to you. I'm worried about what might be inside.
Alright. Oh no, it's a trap! I didn't see that coming. Yo, here we go. Shite. Seriously, that didn't hit any of the other two guys? Fuck off. Oh, come on. Come on. There we go. Got it. Jesus. I am worse at this game than I remember. It is embarrassing. I thought this was gonna be a fucking breeze. But clearly my hubris has got the better of me. Alright, so this is another thing I really hate about this game. That fucking wall I just opened, you can only open it by running along this wall and pressing the A button. Yeah, that's right, you have to be spamming the A button along walls. It's like, as if you didn't have enough shit to worry about in this game. But now you also gotta worry about running along walls and spamming the A button everywhere you go. But anyway, that's enough bitching and moaning about the game mechanics. It is a great game. The mechanics are pretty... The, like, combat is really solid, and the character building is really cool, and it's really fun. And I do enjoy the game, even though it's frustrating at times. But mechanics like that just kind of seem silly to me.
Well, I hope that... Be careful. Oh. But you should take this.
Oh, why, thank you, Pate.
It allows undead to call out for help to one another. across the fissures between worlds. With luck.
Okay.
I hope beak.
Yeah, he just keeps talking the same thing. Be sure you exhaust his dialogue. It's kind of important that you do that. Oh, actually, I seem to recall that. Wait, hold on. Somebody. No, okay. I killed all these guys in here, so let's just pick up this shit, and then there's some stuff downstairs that we can grab that is pretty useful to have, so let's go ahead and do that. Go on down. Poison! Grab a titanite shard, which is nice. Using that to upgrade our weapons. So this thing is called a, I don't know what you would call this, a Pharos face? The point of this is, you need this item called a Pharos lockstone to open it up, but I don't have any. And, you get a ton of them later on in the game. You can always come back to one of these places. They open up, like, secret passages and areas, and they do special things. But, you know, they're not, like, essential to have. The real reason we came down here is so we could get what is in this room. Oh shit, that was a shield bash. Oh. Killing me, bro. Killing me. There we go. And the life ring. That's right. You know that ring you can get as a starting gift? You can get it here if you don't pick it as a starting gift, which is really fucking early on in the game. So now I have a higher max HP. Now, here's another thing. You see those barrels off in the distance there? Boom. Headshot. Let's go ahead. Go through here. Ooh, he dropped his spear. That's nice. It's actually really nice. The winged spear. It's a really good weapon. Too bad I already got the demon's great hammer. The build was decided by fate long ago. You're gonna want to watch when you're blocking, be sure to watch shield bashes, because a shield bash will do more damage to blocking targets. Just a quick FYI. I feel like I'm starting to get in the hang of this build a bit more. It's just kind of hard to manage stamina in general. A bit different than what I'm used to. A lot slower playstyle. I mean, this is really, like, the first time I play any Souls game. This is usually the kind of build I go for. But I've just been, like, playing a bunch of Dark Souls 3, especially. And Dark Souls 3 is really fast compared to this. The fighting, the combat style in general, this is pretty slow. Just in the way you move, and how fast your rolls are, and how far your rolls can carry you away, and whether or not you can drink Estus while moving also is a big factor into that. But anyway, that's enough of me talking about the overall changes between Souls games and excusing how bad I've been by doing so. We unlocked this shortcut. It's a pretty nice shortcut to have. Let's go ahead and head down to the boss area here and fight what is usually the first boss of the game, if you don't just fucking kill the Dragon Rider by watching him jump off the edge, like we did. Alright, let's go. Sure to kill that guy. No, you can't open this door, it's locked. Now, if you're in human form, and you have to be sure that you're in human form when you come down here, and this is actually really important, you need to summon our good friend, mild-mannered Pate, the NPC that we talked to. And you can also summon this guy. He is another NPC that is exclusive to the Scholar of the First Sin edition. Now, he's fucking awesome. He's, like, probably one of my favorite characters. He's, like, to me, he's the Solaire of this game. He doesn't have any dialogue. He doesn't show up anywhere. But the first time I played Dark Souls 2, I played Scholar of the First Sin edition. And he is... Sellsword Lewitt is at almost every freaking boss fight, and he's just the best. He's such a good character. He has two shields, and he just aggroes people and just takes hits, and that's all he does, and it's so helpful to have. Oh, and there's another guy here. Sure. I'll summon. This is an actual person. So I'm going to have three people helping me with what is the easiest straight-up fight in the game. And it's going to be awesome. I'm really excited. Let's go ahead and give this guy a wave. Righty-ho. Let's go.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow.
Pretty terrifying shit there. Now, there's really no point in blocking in this fight. The basic strategy with fighting the giant is go for the ankles, swing at the ankles, just wait for him to... There he goes. He rips his arm off to beat you to death with it at a certain point. Be sure to watch the stomps. Oh, I got hit with the arm. I'm such a noob. But yeah, especially with four guys, this guy, he didn't stand a chance. I'll be sure to wave to this fella for helping me.